Hey. So, let me just check my mic here. I uploaded a video yesterday, but apparently my resolution was all messed up. So, I took the video down. It was basically just me screwing around with Defiler class without too much success. We made it pretty good, but after the stream, I started playing a Toxdweller build. And Toxdwellers are all about bombs and bomb debuff. Let me just check that. Okay. Yeah, it looks like my resolution's all screwed up again for some reason. I don't know why. Okay, I gotta shrink it here. It's really weird. I don't really know scale to window. Nope, that's way too big. Strange. Okay, well, there we go. I think that works. Actually, it's cutting it off a little bit, isn't it? Let's see here. Is all screwed up. I'm just fixing it in OBS right now, so if you're wondering what the heck I'm talking about. Okay, here, I think I almost got it. It's just the resolution's kind of weird. It's like cutting it off a little bit. Okay, that's not too bad anyways. You can see the whole screen. Let's see. Okay, so let me swap over to my display. All right, so this is what we got so far. This should be Tribalist here. This is basically the team that we got. We got six Toxdwellers. One is mixed with Regalis, which lets your creatures share traits, but they have to be the same class, and I don't have all my guys as the same class, unfortunately. So it's kind of a waste, I think. I might change that Regalis to something else. But yeah, these are all the traits. So at the start of battle, this creature inflicts three random enemies with bomb. So this is basically my turn zero wipe the board ability almost. this guy in game. Drag this back up here. There we go. I'll just show you them in game here. So here's Regalis. I've got it in first spot here. Yeah, shares traits. When an enemy's bomb detonates at the start of their turn, there's 50% chance the bomb debuff won't be removed from the creature. After enemy takes damage at the start of its turn from bomb, all other enemies take 30% of that as well. This pretty much wipes out enemy teams. After an enemy's bomb detonates, adjacent enemies take 100% of the detonation damage as well. So basically, even though we're only throwing out three bombs at the start of the battle, it's more than enough to kill everything. And this guy, I haven't fused him with anything yet, or given him an artifact yet, so he's got two available traits. This guy's got one available trait. Oh, I haven't fused him yet. At the start of battle, creature inflicts three random enemies with bomb. Enemies' bomb debuffs have an independent 50% chance to detonate one additional time for each Toxdweller in your party. So, Tribalist changes this guy to a Toxdweller. And basically, yeah. You're almost guaranteed to get four detonations, I guess. Because we have six Toxdwellers, and yeah, that's really strong. What else can you say? This creature's attacks deal 75% more damage and afflict the target with bomb. Now this guy, I need to get some way of getting him to attack even more. This creature starts battles with 200% more speed. He has a ton of speed, but he starts at the bottom of the timeline. This creature deals 75% more damage when it's not their turn. Oops, I think that's just from his. Yeah, it's from his Hermes Treads. That's what I called it. Rend and Tear he also gets from his Netherstone there, the glossy bubble. When it kills an enemy, it attacks the creatures adjacent. Doesn't really matter on this guy. This guy's got an interesting relic too. I gave him Fractal Explosion, which I believe is basically a spell that adds bombs, and then his trinket or the Netherstone is just a bunch more speed. It's like 30% more speed. He gets really high speed as well, but this guy gets an insane amount because he gets 200% at the beginning of the battle. What I should do is make him give everybody else speed as well. That would be really nice. Okay, and then this guy's got imminent danger. After your creatures attack an enemy with bomb, the potency of the bomb increases by 20%. It's kind of nice. But I don't get that many attacks, so I don't have anything giving me like additional attacks or anything yet. So I kind of got to figure something else out for that. And then this guy's has an open artifact trait slot. He has no artifact right now. And this, after an enemy with bleeding dies, and I have the anointment where everybody's bleeding all the time, this creature deals damage to all enemies equal to 20% of the dead creature's max health. So as soon as something dies from bomb, this thing activates and it does 20% of their max health to all the other creatures, which also causes them to die. So it's kind of a nice synergy that I found. And yeah, you just use one anointment. Plus you're getting, another an extra debuff. And the bleed itself does a lot of damage, especially to bosses. Holy crap. So yeah. What else do we have here? Yeah, that's what we already looked at. Okay, this guy has Defender Provoke. Enemies take damage from their bomb debuffs. So he's always provoking. After this creature provokes, your creatures gain 35% defense and speed. All effects activate when a creature provokes will activate an additional time. I don't know if that helps bomb, because I think when he activates bombs, it just it erases all the bombs and all that. But I kind of need another way to add more bombs. But really, these are my only two bomb appliers, these two guys. Everybody else, I haven't really given them any items or anything to boost their speed up enough to make them really good bombers. But yeah, so that's how it is right now, anyway. The only problem is bosses. I can't seem to kill bosses effectively enough. I can get them down. I've got Caliban loaded right now, and he is just messing me up. Yeah, you can see how effective this is. These guys are all dead before they can even do anything. He threw a bomb on every creature, so I think he cast his Netherstone spell or his artifact spell, which didn't get a chance to do anything, so let's just make this as easy as possible. Yeah, I just want to look at the battle history there, see what happened. Can see all these shrapnel blasts going off from the bombs detonating. Okay, so these guys, oh, they gained a lot of stats at the start there. What is it in favor of escape? I had to look that one up. In favor. Oh, it's an arbiter skill. In favor of escape. After start of battle, effects are determined. 40% of this creature's speed is added to that of all your added to your other creatures. Okay, wow, that's really nice. Okay, moving arbiter, it's called. Where do you even get arbiters? Do I have those? Damn, that's kind of insane, actually. So they have a they can do that with everything. Okay, that's really crazy. Huh. Might have to get in on that. Jesus. Thing had a lot of speed. If it's giving everything else. 40% was only 256K or whatever, 215K. Anyway, okay, so this guy took bleed damage and bomb damage, he died. He didn't have very much health. And then the shrapnel blast hits everybody else for another 30 to 50K damage, it looks like. The sharing is caring thing. I don't know. What is that? Oh, that's my guy's. Sharing is caring. Oh, so. When it detonated, it did 100% to the guys beside it. That's why. And then that triggers a bunch more shit. So, yeah, basically, this just like kills everything before I even get a chance to do anything, usually. Really strong. Like, really strong against just the normal enemies that you fight. This is on instability 5, too, on the highest realm depth. Oof, what's going on here? I have no idea what just happened. Right after I say that, I just get w wiped out. Okay. What the hell was that? A Carver sadist. I have no idea what the hell he did. He must have something where he kills somebody, he keeps attacking or something. I don't know. Somehow he gained 68K attack there. We were taking damage from some realm attribute or whatever. He casts Blitz Howl. Okay. I don't know how the bombs didn't actually kill him. That's kind of weird. Weird. It just destroyed everything else. He didn't take any damage, though, for some reason. All right, well, whatever. I don't even know what that was exactly, so I don't know how to do anything about it. Is there a relic that does anything to do with bomb? I didn't mean to do that. Inverted barrier burning mending. Defense, poison. I don't see anything about bomb on any of these. It's kind of a niche debuff almost. I guess it would be on a speed relic, right? Probably. Maybe like this. Ooh. At the start of battle, the bearer gains 50% speed. Oh shit. Start of the bear's turn, this relic increases its speed by 20%. Ooh, the bear has a 25% chance to start battles at the top of the timeline. This would be perfect for my attacker. Shit, might have to get that unlocked. It's agile buff. Nah. More of just an attacker type ability. That's my summoner one. This one's all about blinding. This one's confusion. It's about making enemies attack each other, I think, or something. I don't know. 1,000 needles. Attacks enemy attacks casts additional time. Frozen. Yeah, there's nothing to do with bombs. That kind of sucks. They should make a relic that does bomb stuff. Think all my perks are maxed. Yes. All right. Do I have that Arbiter? That seems like a really strong one. Arbiter. Oh, nice. What's these guys? Yeah, this fuck yeah, this is awesome. Who do we fuse? Do we fuse the this guy, I think, eh? Fuse him with the Arbiter. This one just cracks me up for some reason. I think the blue one looks the best. I don't know. They all kind of look terrible, to be honest. This one looks really bad. You can't even tell what the hell it is at all. I don't know. Terrible colors on that one. Okay, now I feel like we need some kind of way to attack. Attacks. Oh. Know what we can do. Just need something that lets me get some attacks off at the beginning of the fight. Let's see, what is the. I'm just gonna look up spells here real quick. And see what spells have bomb attached to them. Potency of bomb is increased by 80% of the caster speed. Enemies have a small. Take a small amount of damage and have a 50% chance to be afflicted by bomb. That's fireworks. I think fractal explosion would be the one to use, right? Yeah. Seems to be the only one that really applies bombs to everybody. Well, it does three enemies, so. And I think if they already have a bomb, it just goes to the next enemy that doesn't have one, so. Maybe I can give this. What is he? Oh, he's like a life. Or he's. What? Which one is he? He's this guy, right? Yeah. A gift for you. Wait, we don't really need to afflict them with bomb though. It's like we just need to attack everything. Let's see. Caster attacks random enemies three times. Each attack does 15% normal damage. Caster attacks target for you once each turn. No. Random enemy. No. Caster attacks each enemy two times. And your creatures gain 10%. Oh, this is the ultimate spell. It's Avatar of Aeolian. Man, that would be a nice spell to have. Let's see. Fury Swipes is target attacks random enemy creatures three times. Each attack does 25% normal damage. Target attacks random enemies three times for 200% damage, then it dies. Oh. Target gains a massive amount of attack. At the start of its next turn, attacks a random enemy. Mind control. Ooh. Oh, it's an ultimate spell. Enemies are afflicted with bleeding, and this creature attacks each enemy. Yeah, I think the best one you can use is Adrenaline Rush. Caster attacks random enemies three times. Do I even have that one? Apparently, I don't. Oh, it's from the Venadon shop. Hold on a sec, I gotta sneeze. Oh. Okay. So we could go buy that from Venadon anyways. It's a pretty good spell. It's like the best one really for this guy anyway. Oh, and we'll use those other ones too, actually. Where is that? Fractal Explosion. Chant these to he's death, right? Yes. Death, we'll do more charges, we'll do chance to cast after attacking, I guess. Chance to cast twice, chance to provoke, generous. Yeah. What did I do? Oh, more charges. Oh, you can only do it once. You can only have that spell once. Damn, I didn't know that. Well, guess that's that. Chance to dodge 88%. Wow. These guys have more health or something? I don't know. Okay. Oh, everybody's blinded, so we can't even put any bombs on anyone. There we go, there's one bomb. Boom. What the hell? What is preventing all the damage? Less stat loss, always crit, no additional attacks, more damage dealt, less damage taken, I guess? Chance to resist damage, 32%. I don't know, Jesus. All right. I definitely need to get more ways of throwing bombs on people, for sure. This is kind of crazy. Yeah, that guy's dead now. How much, 198k, 200k, 200k. Okay, let's just do this. There's no way my guys are going to kill them. Okay. We can take this off. Enchant it with something else. Give generous, I guess. There, now we got a way to apply more bombs. Extra defense. Weird how it just like destroys some of them, but the other ones not so much. Wow. I guess I actually have a lot of dodge, huh? That speed is pretty crazy for. Okay, why are they taking zero damage from all this? I don't get it. Shrapnel blast. So that gives my guys 62,000 speed. Oh, maybe it's because of the nemesis thing. Oh boy. Damn. All right. Still killed them. I just don't understand why shrapnel doesn't do any damage. Makes no sense. Spatter doesn't do anything either. Like, what the hell? Is there defense? Oh, his defense is insane. 600k? 500? 450? 640? Wow, okay. I guess they just have a shit ton of defense. Crazy. Oh, what was this one? After this creature attacks, decreases target's defense. So he provoked, but oops. Did the bombs go off? Oh wow, that guy gained 150k speed. Jesus. Oh, he got it twice because of the provoke effects happened twice. Okay, so it doesn't seem like when he provokes that the bomb actually disappears. But he only took 7,000 damage from that bomb. What the fuck? That's weird. Okay, well. What happened there? This bomb just disappeared. Took zero damage from bomb. 0000. Why does my bomb do no damage? It makes no sense. I don't know if we just need to buff our speed even higher for our bombs to do damage sometimes, because it seems like they just don't do any damage sometimes. What's this? Each enemy gives 25% of their attack, intelligence, defense, speed to your creatures in the corresponding positions. Wow. I didn't even know she had that spell. That's pretty sweet. Okay. Let's see, how much speed does this guy have? 157K, that's not too bad. He's got more than that. My like actual speedster guy. Nice. Seems like my guys actually do pretty good damage too. Immune to spell damage? Yeah, I don't think we do any spells. It doesn't matter, I'm not gonna beat Caliban, I don't think. Pretty sure he's gonna wipe the floor with me. One sec. Wish I could figure out why the shrapnel thing doesn't do any damage most of the time. Maybe it's just because they have so much more defense, I guess, and it's only like a percentage of the original damage. All right, time to die. Oh boy. Oh, he's back alive. Nice. Whoa, what the hell was that? Well, that's it for this guy. Caliban, I hate you. All right. I don't know what to do. Were our bombs even doing anything to him at all? Bleed does, like, way more damage. Yeah, the bomb only did 55k damage that hit. Apparently my parasite guy hit for almost a million. I don't know. I feel like bleed is doing all the damage and my bombs aren't doing shit. Like that bomb hit for zero damage. Ugh, so frustrating. I don't know. Do I continue with this build? I can't kill bosses. I can kill everything else pretty easily, but bosses seem to be, like, impossible. What's this guy doing? He's casting minor healing a billion times. Nope. Not very good at against killing bosses or gods either. I think this build is a dead end, to be honest. I tried bombs. Bombs strong against normal enemies. Bombs not good against anything else that has a lot of stats. Unless I'm just playing it wrong, I don't know. Like, if you can get a guy to attack like 50 times and increase the potency by 20% every time, then it's pretty good, but I just want to look at the bomb traits here just a second, just to make sure I'm not, like, missing something really crazy. The potency of enemies' bomb debuffs are shared with each other, but enemies take 50% less damage from this debuff. When an enemy takes damage from bomb, it has a 50% chance to take it a second time. This can repeat multiple times in a row.
That's still not gonna
push it over, like, enough damage. After your creature's attack an enemy with bomb, the potency increases by 20%. I have that. I think. I do have that on, right? Pretty sure. It's this guy, I think. Yeah, he's got it. So that applies to my whole team. So my whole team's increasing the potency of bombs, but still not enough. Enemies' bomb debuffs have an independent. I already have that. Mega bomb. That doesn't even have anything to do with bombs. Oh, not quite a dud. When an enemy's bomb detonates at the start of the turn, there's a 50% chance the bomb debuff won't be removed. It's pretty good. Yeah, I'm not really missing anything that's going to increase my bomb damage a ton. The only thing that's going to increase it is speed. And, like, I've already got a lot of speed on these creatures. This guy gets up to, like, 200k, 500k right off the bat. So, I don't know. I just don't know what to do. What does astrologer do exactly? Apparently, he's got a bunch of apocalypses in his party right now. Creature with the highest max health starts battle at the top of the timeline. If your creatures have at least three debuffs, they defend. If you have at least three dead creatures, your other creatures have a 20% chance to resurrect one of them with 50% health. It's kind of nice. If your creatures have at least three buffs, they gain a random minion at the start of their turn. Creatures have less than 80% health, they heal themselves for 20% of their max health at the start of their turn. Creatures, your three creatures with the highest intelligence always cast their topmost spell gem that has at least one charge and isn't sealed at the end of their turn. If your creatures have three debuffs, they're resistant to debuffs. That would go really well with that one avatar. If your creatures have at least five buffs, when they are killed, they are resurrected with 25% health. Oh, wow. Your three creatures with the highest attack always attack at the end of their turn. If your creatures have at least seven different minions, their attacks instantly kill enemies in normal battles. Huh. Creatures with the highest intelligence don't consume charges when they cast spells. Turn. Wow. Kind of interesting, but it's not really that strong. I feel like. Animator might be fun, I don't know. Blood Mage, Kabbalist. Cleric, already played quite a bit. Defiler was fun, but not strong enough. At least I couldn't make it strong enough to kill bosses effectively with my war hogs. What does this guy do again? You got the same team, it looks like. Must have been just checking these things out. Oh, inverted, right. When your creatures reduce each other's stats, they gain those stats instead. Creatures are immune to blighted. Inverted. Creatures heal enemies instead of damaging them with attacks and spells. And damage allies instead of healing them. This debuff is removed after enough has been done. I wonder if that would be good with that team I just had. Let's try it out. I just want to see how it works with this inverted buff. Not well, apparently. Less damage taken, damage every turn, heal every turn, extra intelligence. Jesus. Just stomped all over me instantly. The fuck was that even? Bloodburst. Okay. Let's try it again. Maybe there's a weird spell or realm thing that just... Okay. Apparently this inverted buff doesn't fucking really do shit. At least doesn't feel like it. Yeah. Okay. That was, yeah. Dreamshade Druid. What is Druid again? Apparently I was using these dudes. Winter Aspect and Aspect of Seasons. These guys are fun, though. Wait, what? 4 out of 2? What the hell? Okay. I think this is a bug. I don't know how you can have 4 out of 2. Anyway. Okay, so at start of battle, your creatures gain a random buff for each creature missing. At start of battle, if you have at least 5 creatures missing, your creatures gain 4 random traits. Okay. So we get four random traits. Oh, that belong to their race. Okay. Your creatures have a 10% chance to cast spells an additional time for each creature missing from your group. This can occur repeatedly till it fails. Your creatures start battles with 20% or max health. You can have three additional creatures in your group. Okay, so you get four creatures, basically. Interesting. Creatures deal 20% more for each creature missing. So we essentially always have five creatures missing unless we have more than four creatures in the group. Creature 7, independent, 10% chance to dodge for each creature missing from your group. Let's start a battle, the creatures have 10% chance to move to the top of the timeline. What if we just put the fucking, let's just deposit these two dudes. What if we took our Blade Master and, like, what other extremely strong stuff do we have? Enemies deal damage. Yeah, that one's nice. Take him. Can we take two? What? We can have two avatars? Oh shit, dude. What does this one do anyway? Man, I didn't even know you could have two avatars. What the fuck? Man, I'm such a noob at this game. 400 hours in. This creature is immune to debuffs and takes 50% less damage. The creatures always dodge and deal critical damage, but take 50% more damage. This guy always dodges, but he's immune to debuffs, and he takes 50% less. That kind of sucks, actually. I don't know why I even made this guy. After your creatures gain a stat other than attack, they gain 50% of that stat as attack. Maybe Alexandria? After creatures are healed, they gain a random buff. Percent less indirect damage as this creature's attack that sets the enemy's stats equal to its lowest stat. Okay, so everybody's bleeding all the time. We get healing from bleeding. We deal more damage. Enemies deal less damage. Creatures gain a buff. They gain 15%. We need something that buffs us. We need another avatar, to be honest. No, we need this. Okay, who's another really strong avatar we could use? That'd be really nice. Venadon would be pretty good. I think I had this one on, yeah. So it looks kind of cool. Oh no, you are only allowed to have one. Wow, that's so dumb. Why does it just tell you that when you're like actually doing it? All right. Fine, we'll only take one avatar. What are we gonna take then? Scooters end a minute, 50% chance. The hell? Dodged, dodged. Chance to dodge 81%. Wow. These things, like, bleed doesn't even work on these things, or what the fuck? Enemies cannot lose stats and are resistant. Oh, great. Jesus. The hell happened there? Took 4 million damage, crit. Recompense. Recompense. Oh, 'cause yeah, spark tails do that, don't they? The hell? That's like no stats. What the fuck? Okay, how many times does he cast that? What the fuck? Okay, that was like really stupid. 800? What? Your creature's gain a massive amount of stats. What the fuck? That's not a massive amount. What is his intelligence? 38,000. That's probably why, I guess. Still weird. You'd think it would still be more than that, but whatever. The hell keeps killing him every time. Oh, Kirasuti Goman, that's like his thing, isn't it? Temporary, what? After this creature attacks and the damage exceeds 25% of the target's maximum health, this creature and the enemy are killed. Oh, we're getting a bunch of temporary traits, aren't we? Oh, he gets traits from his class, doesn't he? That's right. Oh, that means that I get avatar traits. Oh, okay. Damn. That's really strong, actually. Holy shit. Kind of sucks, though, that he gets Kirasuti or whatever. I have to look for a creature that has like super useful like family traits or race traits, I guess it would be. God damn. we put a white in there? White would probably be pretty crazy, actually. God damn, we're gonna lose to ourselves. Fuck. That is so dumb. What the hell? How come they can't kill this guy? Makes no sense. Let's see here. Yeah, what if we used a white? I feel like one white that gets like four other white traits would be like really, really crazy, actually. Or what about a storm? If this creature dies, it attacks random enemies 5 times. After your creatures die, this creature gains 25% of their attack, intelligence, defense, and speed. It's a 50% chance to resurrect with 100% health. We did him with what is the one where like every turn it like dies or comes back and like dies or is reborn or something. After your creatures are healed, they gain a random buff. Oh, this is only for the first time in battle.
that's pretty good, actually. What was that? A centaur, right? Okay, that's a lot of fucking stats. And he casts that twice? Holy shit. No, he casts that a lot more times. I guess it's three times? Wow. How much attack does this guy have now? 200k. Nice. Boom. Worm Horde. Come here, dumpling. Nice. Let's see if we can do this. need a way to get our dudes back, though. Oh, man. For some reason, my unicorn's not resurrecting people ever. What the fuck? Why are you not resurrecting? Takes a moderate amount of damage plus 2% more damage for every 1% health it has. Enemies take small amount of damage or mass amount if they're inflicted with debuff. Fuck. shit. Wow. Hey, we finally killed him. Oh god. Okay. We're only gonna get like three choices. Four choices. Creatures can equip cast gems regardless of this class. Creatures have 25% chance to cast spells an additional time. Ooh. This effect can occur repeatedly. Damn, I think that's the obvious winner. Nature gems. Chance random times during a creature's turn, they have a chance to cast one of their Ezreal spell gems. I think mirror image. Your creatures gain a random buff and a moderate amount of stats. Wow. Well, we finally finished this stupid level. Target takes a large amount of damage and is sent to the bottom of the timeline. Wow. That's a pretty nice one. I just buy that one actually just for to have. Your creatures gain rebirth and then they are killed. I'll buy that, sure. It takes damage equal to 10% of the attack intelligence and defense. It's lost in the current battle. Oh wow. Holy shit, that's a nice one for a defiler build. Zombie clap. After all start of battle effects occur, three of your creatures are killed. Supreme Administrator? Is this a new one? After this creature attacks, it casts the last spell that any creature cast in the current battle. Shit. That's interesting. Impington? Sure. Why not? I wonder if we're good enough to kill any bosses or gods, I mean. Crush that guy. About this guy. This is a really tough one for this class, actually. Oops. Oh, nice. What the fuck? this druid build's not turning out too bad. It's definitely lots of room for optimizing. I think I'll get rid of the pill whiz and trade it out for something with more survivability / resurrection mechanic, maybe. Not too sure yet. I think this will be my last realm tonight. Why do I have so much health? Holy shit. It's weird. Alright, yeah, I'll probably play some more of this build here tomorrow. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.